Michael.
Thank you very much.
You know, werewolf in Underworld, vampire in Twilight. Is there something you're not telling us?
I'm an equal opportunities supernatural creature actor.
I actually got the chance and the luxury to watch you play Hamlet in The Young Vic. Last year, I was blown away.
Oh.
As well as you doing so many sort of other films like The Queen and Damn United and Frost Nixon.
Mm.
And then I see you in a big franchise like this. How does Michael Sheen, choose his projects?
Well, I suppose on the whole, I choose things that I would like to go and see myself, you know. Mm-hmm. And also, it has to be a character that I think will be a challenge. It'll mm-hmm. be different to what I've done before. Mm-hmm. Something that my imagination kind of connects with in some way. And in this case, being part of something that actually my daughter could go and see as well. Because, you know, a lot of the other films I've done, she didn't have that much interest in. But this was something that
she's a big fan of.
Yeah, I mean, I got to know about Twilight through her, really, yeah. originally. So she was the person I'd always go to if I needed to find out any information. And also, having done Underworld, I'd seen the world through the eyes of a werewolf, so now I wanted to see the eyes of a vampire.
So you know the whole, yes, you know the whole mythology.
Yeah.
Are you always shocked to see, about the fans and everything, the phenomenon that is global? I mean, people in Singapore know exactly every last detail of your character.
Yeah.
Does that always surprise you? And now that it's come to an end, do you think that this sort of phenomenon is sort of, excuse the pun, but die down, or do you think vampires will live forever?
Oh, I think vampires will live forever. I think they kind of get reinvented, don't mm-hmm. they? They get reimagined by mm-hmm. each generation and mm-hmm. come to mean something different. They symbolize something different all the time.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, in this series of films, I think what Stephanie did in the books was mm-hmm. to be able to, you know, use them as a kind of metaphor for what it's like to be a teenager, to, mm-hmm. to be growing up and to mm-hmm. suddenly discovering that you have these qualities, these gifts, but also these mm-hmm. desires, these mm-hmm. appetites that can be quite destructive if you don't rein them in. And
mm-hmm.
how do you live with that?
Mm-hmm.
I found it extraordinary to be part of something where there's so much excitement,
yeah.
so much anticipation,
yeah.
and so much attention. Like you say, there are people who know far more about my character than I do, and they probably can quote all the lines and that kind of
yeah.
stuff. But that's part of the excitement of it, and that's part of what will be said to let it go.
Right. And talk about the passion of the fans. Has anybody sort of written you? I mean, I know you play the Volturi, and there's somewhat of not really a villain, but, you know, but...
Mm.
What was the most memorable thing a fan has, like, sort of done for you or given to you?
I got all kinds of amazing things sent to me. I remember being sent stuff all the way from New Zealand and, you know, candy from New Zealand and a beautiful little necklace, a symbol, a New Zealand symbol. So there's lovely presents that people mm-hmm. send, but also just going to the premieres and, mm-hmm. and seeing people who've been camping out for days just to be there and see
the most
actors.
Fans
yeah,
in the world.
It's fantastic, and they're very loud as well. I'll always remember how loud they are.
What was the most memorable scene to shoot in, you know, for the two films that you've done?
I think. The scene in this film that I really enjoyed shooting was where Arrow meets Renesmee for the first time, and I always thought that was a good, strong image, the idea of this sort of big, towering vampire, scary, creepy character meeting this tiny little girl and her sort of putting her hand up and touching him on the cheek. I always thought that was a really great scene, so I really enjoyed doing that.
And what's the best thing about being a vampire?
The best thing about being a vampire is being able to take your contact lenses out at the end
Everyone
of the day.
Everyone says that, really.
That's the best thing about being a vampire.
Right, thank you so much, Michael.
Thank you.
Thank you.